fact, it's important that you talked about the systematic investing route for PPF as well. But I want to talk about ELSS.
Yes.
And it's one of the more popular instruments these days for people who are choosing to be in equity, saying that, look, we will invest in an equity-linked savings scheme of a mutual fund. Again, tendency seems to be I'll cut a check of 1,50,000 in a Jan or a Feb. And how important is it to stagger that across the whole year? What are the benefits of doing that?
See, if I have a lump sum right now and I want to put the investment in, talking about a ELSS, a equity-linked savings scheme, which actually invests your money in a mutual fund by investing into a pure equity asset class, which is the recommended asset class and the best performing asset class in this complete category of your tax saving is concerned. Why? Because it invests in equity, and because the investment is meant for long term, more by force rather than by choice. This comes with a lock-in of 3 years. And mind you, this is the minimum lock-in you get in any tax saving scheme. Any other scheme will have a minimum mandate of 5 years. This scheme only gives you a 3-year lock-in, but if you can hold for long term, it's good for you. But coming back to what you just said, Vivek, if I have a lump sum, I should put my money into a debt fund, into a liquid fund, an ultra short term fund, and start doing an STP in such a manner that I can stagger that over the next 12 months. But if I do the investment now, because right now I'm talking about the month of May 19, then I should stagger the money over the next 11 months. If I had done in 12 month period, I would have done typically 1.5 lakhs divided by 12, which is 12,500. Now you have 11 months, so you can adjust the amount accordingly. The key over here is, which you have to be careful about, that you need to be fully invested into the scheme by 31st of March. So accordingly, you can distribute the money depending on the month you want to invest in. You can even invest the complete lump sum right now. But the better part is that you just stagger your purchases over the next 12 months. And if you have money at your end, you may even start an SIP into this category by putting in every month by SIP of 12,500. Then it's just, you just forget about it. And every year, you finish your 1.5 lakhs, no problems.
And also, it becomes important because we live in very volatile markets. And therefore, the principle of SIP, which is to curb volatility for yourself, for your money, works also for ELSS.
Absolutely. The principles of the game will not change. Your rupee cost averaging is what you're talking about, where for every fixed number of units, for a fixed number of amount which I buy, my units will vary. If the markets goes up, I'll buy a lesser number of units. And vice versa also holds true. So therefore, your units will differ because your amounts is constant amount. So therefore, on an average basis, if you look at a 3-year, 5-year, the averaging which it comes out just is in your favor. Only in the scenario when the market goes only vertically up or vertically down is what, when you really don't make money in an SIP format. But that doesn't happen. Over a long period of time, you surely make more money.